We know that most of the church they have donation programs. I know that we always taught to give 10% of tithing, and there are a lot of churches who collect these things, and some of the churches we've seen they collect money to build their buildings and for the development of certain buildings. How do you justify this, and are we still have to give this tithing 10%, or how well can we operate on this? How are we going to develop this?
Okay, that is a problem that is among many believers and churches today, because this whole thing of Christianity has become a money-focused, what shall I say,
Finance.
movement, I should call it, right?
Financial
A
movement.
financial movement, which is not. The purpose of the church is to build the people who come there, who accept Jesus and come into the church. The purpose is to transform them into the image of Christ. And for that you need gifts of the Spirit, and all the rest is there. And the early church never had this issue. The early church met inside homes. There were no buildings. And they met even outside, right? It doesn't matter, because the church means, ecclesia means a gathering, not a building or an organization. But after 325 AD, after Constantine officially recognized Christianity as the religion of this empire, Roman Empire, all the pagan buildings that pagan
Temples.
temples became churches and places of gathering. So they gathered not in homes anymore, but they gathered in these buildings, which was used as the temples for all these other deities. Now, from that time onwards, what happened was the focus was on the building, right? Not on the people anymore. People tried to build the structure, not themselves. The focus was shifted from man to a building. Very sad, because Stephen, when he was having this speech or the sermon to the Jews before he was stoned, he said, God does not dwell in the buildings or the buildings that were constructed by men anymore, right? The hand, with the hands. Because God started living in us. So our body became the temple of the living God. How sad it is, after 300 years of this Christianity, how the focus shifted from building this body as the temple of God to a man-made building, right? And which is wrong, which is not biblical. Now, you asked about finances. Now, finances came because of that, because everyone was trying to construct a building. Right? Together, it's okay to construct a building if you have money. But begging for money to build construct a building is not biblical, because the focus is not on the building.
Yeah, pardon me, it raises another question. I guess if God actually instruct you to build a church or a building, I think he would provide money for it, right?
Exactly, because who is the master of the church? Jesus is the master of the church, and if Jesus is the master of any church, a congregation, if he asks the pastor or the leader of that congregation to construct a building, I'm sure he's responsible to provide the finances. I mean, God is responsible, because if he instructs, then he's bound by it to provide. I don't think God will ever ask you to do something and ask you to go and beg for that. I don't think God is that poor, right? I don't think God is that you know, lack of finances, because the Bible says he owns the whole world, the gold and the silver and the cattle of the thousand hills, and he owns it, and he can provide, if it is his will. But if you are struggling to construct something, that clearly shows that it is not from God. And if you had to beg for money to do something that God has asked you to do, I'm sure it's not the will of God. So simple, it's very straightforward, right? So the tithing, let me come to that. The New Testament, in the New Covenant, in the church, we never read the word tithe. It's always an offering for the saints, an offering for the work of the Lord. Because we see in the first church, they sold whatever they had. They did not bring the 10%. They brought the whole thing. Right? So there was no limit. Right? There was no limit.
No percentage.
But I believe, because tithing started before the law with Abraham, and Abraham being a human being, and he willingly gave 10% to Melchizedek, the priest and the king. And we are of the priesthood of Melchizedek, not of the Levites. Then I think tithing is valid, right? But we cannot limit to 10%. It is what you willingly sacrifice and give to God is what is expected of you, right? It's not 10% anymore. But saying that, I must be very careful here. No one can demand that. It's on your own free will, in your own free will that you give, right? If you want to give, you give. If you don't want to give, you don't give, right?
It's what your heart says.
Exactly. The Corinthians, 1 Corinthians said, chapter 16 says, on the first day of the week, whatever comes to your heart, you separate it to the Lord, right? What you can. No one can demand. But I see now these so-called preachers, prophets, they identify themselves as prophets and demand people to give and to remove their even jewelry and give. You know, I have seen people demanding, you better remove your jewelry and put it to the offering box. How dare these people demand? Right? And I call them glorified beggars. They are beggars. They are worse than the street beggars. Because at least the street beggar is only sitting in one place and asking, you know, begging. But they are demanding. They are more than beggars, and I think they are like, you know, people who are like robbing people. So you cannot demand from anyone. It's not biblical at all. And if you want to do something for the Lord, I'm sure the Lord will provide you if it is the will of God. If not, I think you better stop that project, because it's not from God. And a tithing is what you give on your own free will, not because of compulsion, but because of your own free will. With joy you give to the people, to the church. And the Lord will reward that. And He will never be a debtor to you. Whatever you give, He will reward. Right? He will give it back to you. But don't give expecting the return. Right? It's not a business. Some people people say, take this verse out of context, say 30-fold, 60-fold, 100-fold. That's not regarding the money. That's regarding the word of God. Okay? So, we cannot use that verse to the finances, right? And some people give offerings expecting 30-fold, 60-fold, 100-fold. It's like playing roulette in the casino, right? Yeah. You put, you know, you put some dices there and you expect 36 times or whatever. You can't do that in the church.
So, Lord is not gambling with you.
Definitely not. Yeah.